Hot, flat weather always makes for indecisive spotting. Brad waits and watches before making a critical decision while Jeff buttons up his hunt for the morning. The afternoon sees Mel and Daryl round out a smooth day despite the heat. Daryl shows us how to properly dress a Cabela's shadow-free blind and how he puts the geese in the hunter's laps. All in all, that's four more great hunts closer to the finish line.
There you go.
I'm Claudio Ongaro, and I take people hunting. I woke up one day as a 27-year-old school teacher and said to myself, I'm going to build a hunting lodge. That was in 1994. Now I lead my dedicated team of guides for 63 days each fall, exposing my clients to some of the best waterfowl hunting of their lives. Controlled chaos, epic hunts across 5 million huntable acres. We are hired to hunt. So here's the situation. I thought what I had was a pottle hunt on one pea field, and then I had what I thought was a combo, got permission on it, seemed like a classic no-brainer, right? Ducks hitting the puddle, feeding with the geese. I mean, how much better than that can you get? I go by there, the one field is being cultivated, so the ducks aren't gonna be going in there and right around the whole pond. So that one's done, it might reestablish. The other one, the geese kind of aren't going in there. They're going into another field, the ducks are kind of scattered. So that's kind of blown out. I've told the guys to scramble the jets a little bit because I was a target on that one. And the night is still young, we're not gonna totally panic yet. Brad's hunt, I thought looked good. And we'll just, he and I will talk back and forth, and I already let the other guys know that it ain't looking so good for me. So, I mean, as much as I would love to hunt that one, it's not a hunt right now.
Well, they're in there. I don't know that there's the number there was this morning when I got the permission on it. It's warm out tonight though. I don't even know if we're gonna see all the birds feed tonight. When it's warm like this, you might not see them all in the afternoon. I'm undecided right now. It's the other hunt's better and it's a combo. There's no ducks on this. I mean, I could use this in the afternoon. They're not in the swaths, they're in the combine stuff. So maybe I'll stick around for 10 minutes, see what pans out, see if we get some more birds in here. And then it's time to make a decision on which one to go with. We'll see if we stick it out here and put it to bed, or if we go fly north and check the other target, which looked good when I was by it earlier. So I don't know, we'll give it 15 minutes and see what pans out.
Well, some of these road allowances, they're not very much of a road, but we do what we do to get into them. A little bumpy this one. Shake Ralphie up a bit, but he's been on a lot worse.
Feeling pretty good. Quite a few honkers. Specs.
Oh yeah, it's a hunk for sure.
Hey buddy.
Hey, how's it going?
It's all right.
What's the word?
Oh no, I probably got 180 honks. I figured 20 specs. That's my figure on it.
Uh huh.
Coming from far enough away. My only issue here uh-huh. is the way this whole where they're feeding.
There was more in here tonight, and where they're feeding is right by the road. I can't stop there to get a count on them. So I'm still just waiting here for them to leave to get an accurate count of what I'm hunting.
Okay, you feel good about it? Well, then hunt it.
Yeah, I'll hunt it.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah, all right.
All right, thanks, bye.
I'll talk to you later. Bye. Yeah, bye.
And that's it. So it's Brad and Jeff in the morning. Jeff's doing a big duck and goose combo on swath barley, and Brad, it's on actual swaths too.
Well, we're hunting just in a swath field here. The birds were a little lower. We moved up the hill, not peaked, but we're on the crest here in a swath field, so it's warm this morning. There's no wind hardly at all. You always like to have a little bit of wind to help set the birds up. We don't have much at all here, so they can come in either way anyway, so we left a great big hole for them and short legs so they don't have to follow up a leg very far, and got about 10 more minutes here before we're legal time, and we'll see how we're doing.
Hello, hello, hello.
Right in front. Don't move, don't move, don't move.
Rip them. Somebody get ready and shoot. Shoot.
Take the duck.
More ducks on the right, on the right. Straight under the sun, coming straight in, guys, low. Get ready. Off to the right a bit. Rip them.
Get ready, boys, get ready. Right in front, off to the right a little bit. Rip them! All right, boys, we gotta do a pickup. Three, four. Bring those up here, Andy. How many you got there now?
Six specs and a honker.
Okay, that puts us right. I had us at 18. The honker can stay there.
Yeah, that way he can shoot one more spec.
When do we shoot to Canada?
That means you gotta shoot ducks.
Okay.
Then you gotta shoot that.
Oh. We got an update from the boys from Team Awesome. Jeff, 18 speckabelly, 20 ducks. Brad, 19, 4 of them are specks. So Brad's got 15 Canadas, 4 specks. Good work, boys. So it's all good. Good morning. Woohoo! That's good. Anytime they shoot a bunch of birds in the first hour, that's good. Makes you feel good. Makes you feel warm and happy inside.
Robos are on there, Andy.
Robos are on.
Okay. I like this setup. We look good.
We're ready.
That worked out pretty well.
Get ready, right in front, off to the right a little bit. Rip them! One. Here he is, right there, on the deck. Whack him. We're gonna pack up here now. We've got our limit of ducks. We're just about, we're a couple specks short of a limit. We got a few honkers. So we're gonna save the last couple birds for the afternoon hunt for the boys. So they'll have a few to clean up this afternoon, and it'll be a perfect day. So all in all, it's been a real fun morning. So we'll get packed up and head back to the lodge and reset for this afternoon.
Ready?
Yep.
Well, the wind's wrong. Rely on this wind finder all the time. It couldn't be more wrong right now. It's usually right 80% of the time, it seems to be right. It couldn't be more wrong right now. It's supposed to be out of the north-northwest. I don't know. It's blowing out of the northeast heavy right now.
Well, it's not going to affect it much doing what it is now or going the other way, but...
But what are you set up for? That's the decisions that you guys got to make.
I'm set up for straight north right now. It's easy to make the adjustment, but...
Is it going to flip? Then what do you do, right?
Is it going to flip? Yeah. When it's light wind like this, it's not bad, but that's always when you get the wind switch. If it's heavy wind, it generally stays. But we're only going to have, I believe it's 11K this afternoon, and 15K in the morning. So we don't know yet if we're going to use my hunt this afternoon. It looks like we are, but unless Claudio can put something together on ducks, but it's not looking good. So we'll be using mine, which is a pretty nice combo. I think I might have 300 or 400 ducks on the hunt. That's about it. But that's plenty if they do it. Plenty. All we need is 10 flights of ducks, 4 fall a flight, we're good.
This afternoon we got 14 geese to clean up, 3 specks, and the remainder we can shoot honkers. There are 14 honkers. Jeff did pretty good this morning, so we're just gonna finish it up, but we're getting ready to go on the hunt. Mel's inside waking the guys up right now, and I'm just loading my gear up for the hunt this afternoon. So we'll get this guy loaded up, because he can't jump that high. Goes in the wrong one. He thinks we're hunting already. Come on, over here, come on. In this one, come on, kennel up. Right here, kennel. Kennel up. Good boy. That's better. Well, he follows us around all summer at the fishing lodge, and comes out here and then out to Saskatchewan and hunts birds all year, so he's got a pretty good life. But hunting experience is huge. The more hunting experience they get, the better dog you're gonna have, especially high volume hunts like snow goose hunts and anything where you're shooting a lot of birds. The more retrieves they do, the better dog it's gonna be. Get them out there, shoot lots of birds over them. Get them different hunting scenarios, situations, you'll have an awesome dog. Just get the basics down when you first get them, do all the training and maintain that, but more scenarios, he'll be a good dog when you're done with him. Yeah, it'll be a good hunt this afternoon. Unfortunately, we can only shoot 14 more geese for the day, but it's always nice going out there and you can shoot a full limit, but we'll get 14. It's a bunch of Canadas. I'm sure we'll be able to clean them up pretty quick. Should be a good evening. We got to the field here, and there's combines out cutting the field. We're standing crops pretty tight to where we were hunting, so we gave a call to the farmers to make sure they were okay with us still going in. We had a backup plan if not, and they said good to go. They said, why are you even calling us? Just get out there and get the geese out of the field. So we're gonna set up. Everything should be good. It's still early. They shouldn't even be done before we even get the birds start flying tonight, so shouldn't be an issue. Right, with these birds, 90% of the time, if they're not coming in on you, it's because your hide's not good. You see there's tons of stubble in this field, but it's really small and fine. It's not good. If you stuff that in the straps of the blinds, you open the door once, it falls out. So you gotta pick up this longer stuff and actually get it right into the straps on the blind. And that way, with the doors here, it hangs over both and covers the opening and covers over the faces and everything there too. And that helps you hide a lot better. Works good and the stubble stays into the straps. But these Cabela's shadow-free blinds, they're awesome. They're low profile, they're super comfortable. They're just a good product all around.
All right, so we just get a call from Daryl, and the field that his birds are in was still partially standing, and the combines are still cutting there, which is fine. So we just talked to the landowner, called him right in the combine, said, hey, do you mind if we set up? And he said, yeah, go ahead. Daryl's setting up. So it's amazing, because lots of stuff can go wrong, you know, and a lot of stuff needs to go right for it to happen. So we'll know in a little bit if he gets it done or not. So hopefully it goes well.
There, we're ready to go. Everything's set up. We got a north wind. We're hunting ducks, honkers, specks. We're hunting a side chute, basically, and all we're doing is trying to funnel the birds right down this chute in front of the hunters, which are in the willow blind just behind us. The birds should start coming, I'm hoping, in within a half hour. It should be good, and they've been hitting this particular spot every time they've been in the field, so I think it'll be a good hunt. Okay, get ready. Get ready. Get ready. Go, 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 go! Good shooting, fellas. Good shooting. They're coming from the left. And they're pretty low already. Let's go get him. Somebody come with me.
Jeff, you and Jeff, you and Ty shoot.
Go, 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 go! We got all our geese. We're done geese for the day. And yeah, we're just waiting on ducks now, and they seem to be starting to fly a little bit. They've been really late coming out, so. We'll see what happens.
All right, so just got word from Mel. He's chipping away at his ducks, which is good. Daryl said his honkers are just starting to fly. On the spotting front, a whole bunch of uncertainty for us. I mean, the harvest is just rocking and rolling, which is a good thing. I mean, crops getting cut, so that helps us. The farmers, I mean, thank goodness that the weather's good enough, they have a window where they can actually harvest, but there's combines rocking and rolling, there's trucks flying. I mean, you can just feel the energy and the buzz in the community, which is really good. And of course, now we gotta react, because every time a crop gets cut, it creates more opportunity for birds to move in, settle, so good for us, but we gotta be on our toes so we can find the most consistent pattern for the morning. So, good things are about to shake down, and you know how the evening ends up? Well, we'll know in a couple hours here. Kill him, guys, kill him!
Watch, there's five on the right, really low. Them guys, right up front, shoot them, right up front. There you go. A single coming straight in. No, it's a honker. It's a honker. Go ahead, kill him, kill him, kill him. Kill him, guys, kill him. Shoot one of them, shoot one of them. Done. We finished up our birds for the evening. We shot 13 Canadas, one spec, finished off with 14 birds for the day. We're still getting rolled hard here by lots of birds, but unfortunately we're limited out for the day, so we'll have to get some more tomorrow. But it was a good hunt, lots of fun, finished the birds in nice and tight. We let a few go, missed a couple, and worked more birds in. We had lots of birds, so it wasn't a problem. We got here and the combines are in the field. Pretty well, you know, what can go wrong will go wrong, but we had a backup hunt option if we had to, and we just talked to the farmer. He said, not a problem, it'll be done in here right away. They were done and out of here before the birds even started flying, and before we even finished setting up, so everything worked out. It was just a perfect evening, perfect day. These guys shot 40-40, and we'll get back early tonight, and I'm sure they'll have a few drinks and a nice meal, and you know, another day and a half for them.